Scanning the exhibition area. Module head found. Establishing coordinates. Assessing structural integrity. Head location.
Shit, it's dark here. I got a bad feeling about this.
The Neptune is an underwater city that has been located at the bottom of Lake Lazur since 1944.
Scanning the exhibition area. Module head found. Establishing coordinates. Assessing structural integrity. Head location. Chelome floor. Structural integrity compromised. Excessive pressure detected.
Excessive pressure?
Poor thing. It's crushing her. It's like they dropped a whole building on top of her. Oh, Major, it's just too cruel. It's unbearable.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
The next
Scanning the exhibition area. Module head found. Establishing coordinates.
Shit, it's dark here. I got a bad feeling about this.
Scanning the exhibition area. Module head found. Establishing coordinates.
Shit, it's dark here. I got a bad feeling about this.
Thank you. Access granted.
Crispy fucking. Where's the shit ass way out of here? Underground or something? Fuck me. Where am I supposed to find the head?
You need to enter Icarus Hall. It is located on the second story of this venue.
So where's the entrance?
Unfortunately, I do not have this information. Everything's got mixed up after the malfunction.
No shit, Sherlock.
Have you considered powering the Beluga?
How is that supposed to help?
I don't know. It's just a suggestion.
Well, I guess it can't hurt to try. It's not like we've got a lot of other options. Tereshkova, where's the power room around here?
At the very top.
Fantastic. Super cut off. Just what I always wanted.
So, what will it be? Authorization, Major Ne-
Where's the shit-ass way out of here? Underground or something? Fuck me. Where am I supposed to find the head?
You need to enter Icarus Hall. It is located on the second story of this venue.
So where's the entrance?
Unfortunately, I do not have this information. Everything's got mixed up after the malfunction.
No shit, Sherlock.
Have you considered powering the balloon?
How's that supposed to help?
I don't know. Just a suggestion.
Well, I guess it can't hurt to try. It's not like we've got a lot of other options. Tereshkova, where's the power room around here?
At the very top.
Fantastic. So we're cut off. Just what I always wanted.
Submersible vehicle. It can reach speeds of up to 78 kilometers per hour and is able to carry out civilian and military missions at depths down to 3,000 meters.
We've learned more about the ocean floor over the last few years than we had during the previous century.
If you ask me, we're better off exploring the depths of the ocean than outer space.
Fascinating. Why is that?
Because you gotta know your home before you can start visiting other people. So what was wrong with the real beta connectors?
Since Collective was originally planned without any discretionary authority, everyone in it was supposed to be equal.
Yeah, we already talked about that. Then why'd they need the beta connectors?
To secure Collective against unforeseen threats from individuals who might wish to control it.
That's impossible. Everybody's equal in Collective. Shit, the Alpha Connector.
Indeed. Intruders, or an opposition force among equals, could try to obtain the Alpha Connector. This could lead to human casualties, which would be unacceptable.
So how could Beta Connectors stop this from happening?
They didn't give their carriers any discretionary authority, but they did allow them to be present within Collective without being a part of it. In other words, they had total autonomy while retaining access to the information network.
So what? That's basically what we have right now.
You're seeing this from a human perspective.
What other kind of perspective could I... Aw, crap. The boss wanted to put beta rings on some robots so no one else in Collective could control them.
Indeed they are. At first, Dr. Sechenov planned to order his loyal twins to guard the Alpha Connector. While logged into Collective, he could control them from anywhere on Earth. At the same time, no one else would be able to give them orders. They wouldn't even know that they exist.
Hold on, Charles. I don't quite get it. Would it be possible to launch Collective with everybody equal, then destroy the Alpha Connector?
Certainly, but that begs another question. Who would choose to do that?
Dr. Sechenov.
Are you sure about that, Comrade Major?
Yeah. I mean, I guess. Thank you. So where's the very top?
Thank you. This is where the power comes from.
Are you sure?
Definitely.
How?
Because this place has my favorite thing in the whole fucking world. A relay.
Really? I thought you were more partial to canisters.
Oh, come on.
I'm dumb, endlessly stupid, and I die because of my stupidity. If somebody buries me, put these words on my tombstone.
What happened?
I tried to run. But I didn't know how to rotate these things on the floor, so I failed. I could have opened the passage. It's a security relay. Looks simple enough. But I panicked and did something stupid. And then wham, blood everywhere. There was pain and that was it.
Yeah, you gotta adjust them by color. Well, shit happens. It's not your fault. I'll tell the tour guide you're, here still. Let's see if this thing helps.
Did it?
Oh, yeah. Right. What do we have here? Tereshkova, do you copy?
Yes, dear comrade. The communication is restored.
So, where's that head of yours?
My head is where it's supposed to be, but Claire's head should be somewhere on your floor. Like I said earlier, something is crushing it with terrible force, like a migraine, like an excavator, like an entire mountain.
I get it. I really do. All your whining is giving me a migraine, too. I'll go look for it.
Saving data.
Authorization. Access granted.
Looks like a maze for kids. This'll be a cakewalk. Jumpy little thing, ain't ya? How do I rotate you, huh? Hey, I think I get it. Now we're getting somewhere.
Do you have any idea what you're doing, Major?
Just a sec.
Is it really that difficult?
Crispy goddamn fucking critters! Oh, for fuck! You know, Charles, I guess, without saying anything, Gotcha! Nice! Easy.
Summer morn, when warmth and beauty mingle, at the path's turn, a carcass lay a sprawl upon a bed of shingle, legs raised like some old whore, far gone in passion, the burning, deadly, poison sweating mass, open its paunch in careless, cynic fashion, ballooned with evil gas. On this putrescence, the sun blazed in gold, cooking it to a turn with eager care, so to repay to nature hundredfold what she had mingled there. The sky, as on the opening of a flower, on the superb obscenity smiled bright. The stench drove at us with such fearsome power, you thought you'd swoon outright. Flies trumpeted upon the rotten belly, whence larvae...
Yes, found the head. We gotta keep moving. Charles, any idea how much time we got left?
I cannot say for sure, but definitely not much.
Finally, I got all her parts. Charles, so after Dr. Sechenov created the new gamma connectors, he destroyed the old beta connectors, right?
Officially, yes. But only the technology used to manufacture the beta connectors was destroyed. The pair of experimental rings were simply removed from all records and declared recycled.
Why go to all that trouble?
He didn't want to destroy the fruits of his painstaking labor. Dr. Sechenov simply kept them as souvenirs.
So where are they now?
They were somewhere in the Sechenov Science Center here at Facility 3826. But they apparently disappeared after the malfunction began.
Apparently.
You see what's going on here, don't you? No one knows anything for sure right now. The rings could be on a lab bench somewhere, or destroyed by rampaging robots.
There won't be any need for them in Collective. Dr. Sechenov and his scientists will be able to solve any problem without him.
I couldn't agree more.
Saving data.